Hey everybody, Chris Filardo here, SG241 from Empire Temple in New York, aka Master Tarko Daman, and for those of you on the dark side, Orin Strago. Now, I don't know about you, but coronavirus quarantine has gotten me down a little bit. At least in the respect that I can't see my fellow guildmates every week for our regular saber practice. And you know, we gotta stay active, even in a quarantine. So, if you've got an outside space like I do, awesome. If not, we're gonna do a little bit of remote learning on our own today, and some things that you can even do in a smaller space. Granted, swinging a saber is a little bit dangerous if you're in an enclosed area, but just be aware of yourself and your surroundings and test out a couple of moves before you begin to make sure you're not gonna break anything or hurt anybody around you. Remember, a Jedi must always be aware of their surroundings. So today we're gonna walk through some very basic stretches and warm-ups to get you going. And then we're gonna walk through some of the things that we might take a few Padawans through from time to time. But of course, at our own experience level. All right, let's get started. So first, no saber needed. Let's just limber up a little. Start to do some stretching. So let's put your hands on your hips and rotate your neck. Count to five in one direction. Stop, other direction. Count to five, two, three, four, five. Good. All right, let's rotate your shoulders. Forward, two, three, four, five, and back, two, three, four, and five. Good. Let's rotate the hips. Put your hands on your hips and really go all the way around. You're kind of getting a little bit of a stretch in your legs at the same time that you do this. Okay? Again, two, three, four, five, and the other way. One, two, three, four, five. Very good. Okay. Let's stretch out our hands a little bit. Let's face it. When you're sabering, you're gonna use your wrists a lot, right? So, put one hand out in front of you, grab your fingers, and pull back so you get a nice stretch in your wrist. We like to call this the force push. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And now down, we like to call this one the sassy sip. Two, three, four, five. Great. Palm up. Grab your fingers, pull them back. We like to call this one Cobra Kai. One, two, three, four, five, and back, Spider-Man. Two, three, four, five. All right, shake it out. Let's do the other side. Palm down, force push. Two, three, four, five, and down, sassy sit. Two, three, four, five. Very good. Palm up, fingers up, Cobra Kai. Two, three, four, five, and back. Two, three, four, five. Very good, shake it out. All right, stand up again. So now, let's do some legs. Pick up one leg up behind you, stretch it out. Pull back just enough to get a stretch in the front. Don't overdo it, and also try to maintain your balance. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. Bring down slow. All right. Other side. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Very good. Bring your feet apart and go down to one leg and hold it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Just go as far as you can. Don't overdo it. If you start to feel like it's hurting, then take it easy. Push a little bit to get a good stretch, but don't force yourself. I myself am not quite as flexible as I would like, but doing this more and more will get you going. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 10. Good. All right. Nice. All right. Let's try going down a little bit more, get a little bit more stretch in that leg. So I want you to do a lateral lunge. Lean all the way down. Rest on your far heel and bend your knee all the way. Again, as much as you can. If you turn towards your leg and lean forward into it, you're going to get even more of a stretch down in here. Good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent. Other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. Great. Let's do a forward lunge. So now, the difference is you're facing forward. You want to keep your legs at about shoulder width, and bend your front knee, keeping your back leg straight. Look at the side. You can see my back leg is straight, with my foot planted, and my toes pointed forward. My left leg also forward, with my knee bent. Good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 9, 10. This is also reminiscent of what you might call a front stance or a forward stance in martial arts. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Alright. Now let's get a little bit of exercise in. Alright? So we need to keep our body moving and our blood flowing. So since we don't have a lot of room, normally, we would do a few laps around the studio space, but for today, we're just going to run in place, all right? So get ready. Pick up those knees so you can make sure you get as much out of it as possible. We're going to do this for a few times. Ready? And go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Don't forget to breathe. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1 more. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Walk it out. Breathe. Catch your breath. We've been sitting around a lot, trying to stay inside and away from people. So it's understandable if you're a little out of breath. I know I am, at least a little bit. All right. Do some jumping jacks. Ready? Stand in place. I'm gonna see you all the way up, legs out, and back down. Okay, we're gonna do 30. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. Great job. Now that we've got ourselves warmed up, I know I'm warmed up. Oh, you're warmed up too. I have been doing something else to keep my body moving as well. A little bit of exercise. I've set an alarm for myself on my phone so that once an hour, for the normal duration of a workday, so 8 hours, 9 to 5, I have to stop what I'm doing, get down, do 20 push-ups and 20 sit-ups. Now, if that's something that sounds good to you, you can do something else or try something completely different. I usually mix it up between push-ups and mountain climbers, for instance. Or sit-ups. Instead of sit-ups, I'll do some leg lifts, or I will do some hundreds, which you might call earthquakes from certain people. If you're familiar with Pilates, you can look it up, you'll see what it is. Planks are great, crunches are great. Anything you can do in your home without a lot is a good way to go. So we've been doing this for almost 10 minutes now, so let's get to the Saber. All right, so. So I think what we're going to do today is let's take a look at some basic motions. All right. Firstly, targeting. Targeting is always something that we need to practice. And since you may not have a partner available to you, measure on yourself. Remember, shoulders are going to be about mid-bicep. So you're aiming right for this area on your right shoulder and your left shoulder. Hips, right around the hip. Same position as you might think. Pretty easy. Then for legs. Let's keep it about mid-thigh. Now in some cases, you may consider this to be more of a mid-strike and a hip, and you may actually go very low for a leg strike. But for today, I want you to just follow with how I'm doing it. So hips, and then legs. Similarly to your shoulder strikes, this happens mid-thigh. And again, this is for safety purposes. So if your opponent is not able to block and you do make contact, you're hitting in the medius part of the body and you're going to do the least amount of damage. Great. So, if you get yourself in a ready position, whatever is best for you, your favorite ward, whether it be right out front, a little off to the side, a low, or even a high, get yourself ready. Now, remember where your positions are. Aim for the right shoulder. And reset. Aim for the left shoulder. And reset. Aim for the right hip. Reset. Left hip. Reset. Right leg. Reset. Left leg. Reset. I'm going to turn this way. We're going to do another round. Now notice I have one foot forward and the other foot back. This is sort of a natural position for a fighting stance that you'll want to be in. It gives you a readiness to be able to move forward or back in any way that you see fit. So, in your ready stance, shoulder shift to the right, back to reset. Left shoulder, reset. Hip, reset. Other hip, reset. Right leg, reset, and left, reset. Now as I'm doing each of these movements, I'm coming from my ready position into a curve of a strike. Everything has a fluid roundness to it. This is going to allow you to build momentum, take a moment to aim, and place your blade where you need it to go. And a general fluidity of motion is going to allow you to move on to your next strike. So try to be aware of the way you're moving. Reach out with your blade, not just with your feelings. And around. And when you get to the end there, don't just stop and back and stop, but give it a little bit of a roundness to it. So when you complete your action, round it out. See how I'm making this whole circle? Round it out. You're going to do this without even thinking after a while. You just get that slow momentum in so you can come right back. And moving in a fluid motion is going to be a lot easier than jerking your blade position to position. Alright, so, very good. Alright, now that we've got some of the basic strikes down, let's look at blocking real quick. When you're blocking, same idea. Make sure you're presenting a target at those main target zones, because that's where you'd be aiming, and that's where your opponent would be. So keep your blade in a ready position, straight up and down, and move it over to your right to block your right shoulder. Note where my shoulder is, where the middle of my blade is. Don't go too towards the tip, don't go too far near the base, otherwise you're going to hit yourself in the head, or you're likely to lose a finger. All right, great. So. Right shoulder, left shoulder. For the hip, you can either bend your knees, lower your guard, and move the blade over to the right or left, or bring your hands up, turn your blade upside down, block to the right, or block to the left. I prefer to do it blade down. Not only do you get more, are you more likely to actually block where you want and actually place the blade where you want. But I feel like it gives me a little bit more fluidity. If anybody has any other insight into some of these movements as to why they think it should be done this way, by all means, please comment. All right. Now for the leg. It's the same thing as that reverse grip. It's not exactly a reverse grip. Note. Please note, because I know a lot of you do this when you practice. My hands never change this position. A true reverse grip is like this. This is a very specific way of using your blade. So unless you intend to fight with a true reverse grip, your hands should never change from this orientation. The inside of your grip should be up towards your blade with both hands. So when you're doing a low block or a shoulder block, or even coming up for a strike like this or an uppercut, keep your hands in this same position. Move your body and your arms and your wrists, and let go if you have to be able to get to that position. That's up to your style, but make sure you keep that gripped correctly. All right. So, low blocks, same way as the upside down grip, all right? So, left leg, come back around, right. Now, you can reset, block, reset, block, or you can do this fluid motion that we sometimes fondly like to refer to as the windshield wiper. Block your left leg, swing around, and block your right leg. My hand positions are not changing for any of this. I may be letting go of it with one or the other, but ultimately I have at least 1.5 hands on my hilt, and I'm pushing away from myself. Very good. Okay, now that we've got some of our basic attacks and defenses down, let's go with Form 1, Sheet Show. And for this tutorial, we'll only do the first half of Sheet Show. Now, Sheet Show.
Sheet Show, or the Way of the Sarlacc, is the first form that all Jedi must learn upon entering the Jedi Temple as Padawans. And this is one of the reasons why it's become one of our favorite techniques to use. That and the fact that, well, as real-world Earthlings, we don't actually know all these forms perfectly. And we're trying to work on more of them to add to our repertoire and really make it feel like a more robust world of lightsaber combat. Now, like I said, we're going to do the first part of this. And Shicho is a walking form. So you are meant to be moving forward the entire time. Sometimes we break up the first and the second half by turning around, but you can truly move forward for the duration. For this instance, we're going to do it as though we're doing it on a stage for a show, and we're going to be doing it stationary. So my footwork is going to be forward and back rather than continuously forward. You'll see what I mean.
So when we normally do this, we take a step, and then another step, and then another step. But if we need to maintain a small area of operation, we need to take steps forward and backwards. But it will put our feet in the same position. So, if I want to start off and take a step forward, I'm supposed to take one more step forward, which would put my left foot in front. But instead, I can move my right foot back, and my left foot is now in front, as it would have been. So if you can get into the habit of simply rocking back and forth, with your right foot forward and then back. This is a good way to do it from a stationary position. Now some folks will prefer to actually change their feet, stepping forward and then stepping forward with the other foot, back to the middle and back forward. You can do either one of these, but personally, I prefer the rocking back and forth. So that's how we're gonna do it now. You do it how you want. So, to begin, we are in a ready, sort of relaxed stance. Then we're going to roll up, feet together, into a ready stance. Salute, if you will, the Jedi salute, as we call it, or the Padawans. So you keep your elbow out, your hands together on top of each other with your blade to one side of yourself. then step forward with your left foot. Cross the bow. Next, bring your blade up for your left shoulder block, around your head, step back with your left foot, slash down diagonally across your body, right to left, or down your shoulder. Now we're going to do the same thing on the opposite. Around the right shoulder, step forward with the left foot, slash down from left to right. Blade up hip, belly cut, the tip of your blade pointing forward, over to the left. Then back to the other side, to the right. Now an uppercut. Bring your blade up, drop it low. As you step, cut up and across yourself from lower left, or lower right, excuse me, to upper left. Keep your blade parallel to the ground, walking forward. There are some variations of Shicho where you come into more of a ready holstered position with your blade facing straight up. For our variation, we're pointing. Next movement is an uppercut to the right. Step forward, uppercut to the right. Good. Now step again, bring your blade up above your head. I like to do a little flourish for this. Bring it up, step forward, cut down. Feet together, thrust forward. At attention, and back. And now you can move to ease carry to continue in your demonstration.
Now I'm going to do that one more time, and I'm going to be facing towards the side so you can see how it's done from that side. You watch my stance, watch the positioning of my blade, and we'll go from there.
So, relaxed, roll up, thrust forward, dropping it low, step forward, and cut up. Good. Above the head, downward slash, feet together, thrust, tension, and back. Very good. Now, I'm going to do that at full speed, so you can take a look.
So there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this remote learning session for today. Hopefully we can do this again. And if any of you have some lessons that you'd like to share for everyone else, please, by all means, I think it would be great to share, especially in this time where we can't actually get together and do this. So don't forget to keep practicing. It's the only way that any of us can ever improve. Even if you're a seasoned veteran, you need to practice these skills all the time to make sure that you are doing things at your best. And of course, the younger folk are going to appreciate your insight and your opinions and your own little flair. So please, by all means, never think that basics are too low level for anyone. It's the only way that any of us can improve is with a good foundation. All right, guys, thank you so much. Good luck, stay safe, may the force be with you. Two sides, one force.